everybody, it's Sierra, the Artsy Badger, and it's the beginning of May, which means it's time to draw some mermaids. So I really was planning on participating in Mermaid this year, but as you may know, sometimes life doesn't go exactly as planned. So although I don't think this is the only mermaid I'm going to be drawing this year, I am not going to be fully participating in Mermaid, in case you haven't already noticed. For today's mermaids, I decided to take some inspiration from a video that Gelarts put out a couple weeks ago, where she drew creatures based off of her houseplants. So I decided to draw mermaids based off of my houseplants. I have recently started purchasing houseplants. I've always liked plants, and I usually always have one or two, but now I have like four or five. So it's not that much, but it is about double what I usually have. And I really liked that video that Gelarts did, and I actually attempted to do exactly what she did, create creatures out of my plants last week, but it was just a bad day and what I came up with was not very good. So I decided to kind of morph that with the mermaid theme, and this is what I came up with. So the mermaid that is in the foreground is based off of my Calathea medallion, I believe is the way that it's pronounced. I also am not 100% sure on the actual species type, I guess. The pot just said Calathea, if I remember correctly, but I kind of had to like reverse image search to find the right species. It could even be a subspecies of that, I suppose. I don't know that much about plants yet. My second mermaid, which is in the background, I suppose, is based off of my bromeliad, and I really couldn't figure out any more specifics than that. Mine has yet to really flower. It just has this sort of bright yellowness to it. I believe it's supposed to flower in red, but who really knows? When coloring in the mermaids, I wanted to stay true to the colors of the plants as much as I could, and so green skin seemed like a good choice for the bromeliad mermaid. I did give her some like pink blush tones still make it seem lifelike, I guess, because I think even if you had green toned skin, you would still have like blood and flesh, right? At least that's how I'm looking at it. And then for the Calathea mermaid, I really like the red tone of the underside of the leaves as well as the stems, so I decided to give her skin a red color. In the beginning, the red is definitely way too bright, but then I go over it with my Copic Chow marker in EO4 and it dulls it down a bit. I also tried to keep the greens all in kind of different families of green, which was about as difficult as I expected it to be. Especially with the bromeliad mermaid, her skin tone, I really didn't want it to blend in with her tail and things. So her skin tone is more of a yellowy, duller green, while her tail and chest piece is more bright. And then for the Calathea mermaid, I made all of her green parts more gray-green, I guess. I also made sure that her hair color, or plants growing out of her hair color, was different than her skin color. And at this point, we're already at the end of the video for the most part. Sorry that this is a bit of a shorter one, but maybe this is a good recovery from last week's long video. I did have a really fun time basing mermaids off of plants. I did originally think that I was going to do that for the entire amount of mermaid, so we'll see if I get another couple in here throughout the month. I sure hope so, but that's about all I have to say. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all next week.